Like, they are 100% there because of heat culture. That can never be mocked again.
We got to get back to the Heat. So they now are going to move and they're going to play against the Nuggets. So I went and looked. So while the Heat just pulled off the incredible by getting to the NBA Finals as an 8 seed, they now run into a team that has been an absolute juggernaut. The Nuggets, just to refresh everybody, because it's been a long time since we talked about the Denver Nuggets because they won so long ago. They lost one game to the Minnesota Timberwolves, and that was in overtime. They lost two to the Phoenix Suns, one of which was by 7 points, in which Kevin Durant had 39 and Devin Booker had 47. They lost another one by 5 points. In that game, Jokic had 53 points, and they lost. Durant and Booker both had 36. And then they did not lose to the Lakers at all. So they have lost a grand total of 3 playoff games, one of which was to Minnesota in overtime, and the other two were truly all-time great performances in tandem by two of the greatest offensive players that we have seen in Devin Booker and Kevin Durant. Those are the 3 games that they have dropped thus far in the playoffs. And so that's who the Heat are facing. I went to go look up if they, you know, what happened during the regular season. And you'll never believe this, Kevin.
Denver won them all,
right? Not really relevant.
Denver did win them all, though, right?
Well, they played twice. Yeah, they
played twice. Won both.
Yeah, they played twice.
Actually, I believe they've won both? Their last 6 against Miami.
Both really good games. They played on December 30th. And the Nuggets won 114 to 119. Haywood Highsmith started for the Miami Heat in that game. I don't think he's going to start in the finals. Another one was February 13th, 112 to 108. So those two games, one was decided by 5 points, the other was decided by 4 points. They started Vlatko Chanchar in that game in February. Vlatko Chanchar, also Brown started. Murray didn't even play in that game. And off the bench for Miami in that game, Orlando Robinson and Jamari Bouye. So, I mean, that's, if there was anything more indicative of the regular season games that you and I are charged with talking about, it is, hey, that Heat Denver game. Yeah, did you see Jamari Bouye in that game? Like, I swear to God, they grow these guys. But going back and looking at some of those box scores, Vlatko Chanchar versus Orlando Robinson, probably not the best indication of me breaking down what could happen in an NBA Finals. I don't know how much I can draw from the regular season games that they played, except that they were highly competitive games. And so I think that's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping that they can be competitive. But as we know, it's been very difficult to be competitive with the Denver Nuggets thus far. I'm so scared to count Miami out of doing anything. I mean, they were huge underdogs to the Milwaukee Bucks. Boston was minus 550 to beat them. You had to bet $550 to win 100 if you wanted to bet on Boston. I know that it feels like they don't have a chance,
when Boston was down 3-0, there were certain like algorithms that still had the Celtics winning the series, which was silly, but also, I mean, yes, it speaks to the numbers that we're talking about here.
Right. I know. And it's, but I guess all I'd say is I know it feels like Miami wouldn't have a chance against Denver, but I'm not counting them out of doing anything anymore. I just can't count them out of doing anything. I you know, they got Jimmy Butler, they got Spoelstra. I'm looking, I just pulled it up. Denver is minus 380 to win the series. So you got to bet $380 to win 100 on Denver. Game one, which is on Thursday night, Denver is installed as 8.5-point favorites.
In game one. So that's eight a lot officially for game one.
8.5.
Wow.
It is a huge NBA line.
Yep.
It really is. Now, I know they've been sitting around while the other team just played a game seven. So fair is fair. But here we go again, right? This is exactly what the Heat have been doing. You know, they're huge underdogs to Milwaukee, too. They're huge underdogs to Boston, yep, too. Like, I do think they ran into teams that have not punished them for their lack of size. Now they run into a team that will immensely punish them for their lack of size. Denver's not just going to go out there and shoot a million threes.
They're going to play. They're going to play every which way.
They're going to get in the mid range. Yep. They're going to.
That's what Denver does. They play every single style. That's what Jokic empowers you to do. He's used all over the floor. He's used as a pick and roll ball handler, as a screener, as a guy coming off screens, going towards the basket, posting up, isolating and backing down guys from behind the arc. I mean, he does absolutely everything. I just think Jokic, with this supporting cast around him on Denver, is a problem that's going to be really, really difficult for Miami to solve. You can't count out the Heat, considering everything that you're saying, Chris. But at the same time, this Heat, this Nuggets roster, Michael Malone and that coaching staff has had a long time to prepare for either of these opponents. And they probably have more time preparing for Miami, considering Miami was up 3-0. I'm sure they know all the inside outs of this Miami team.
And how much pressure is on Bam?
Oh, I know.
To be just an amazing defender. He's not big enough.
But what if he gets in foul trouble?
He's just not. Like, I know. They're going to have to dust off Alonzo Mourning. You see him up in the stands tonight? Yeah. My God, he looks like he could... You see what kind of shape he's in? Good grief. You see him in that suit? I was like, damn, Alonzo Mourning looks like he could go out there and give you 20 and 10. Standing there next to Pat Riley with his arms folded. I'm like, yo, Alonzo Mourning is yoked.
Badass.
Crazy.
Both of them, really. They're both badasses.
He really is. They're going to have to put him out there to, they're going to have to put him out there to give you a couple minutes on Jokic. That stat about Riley, do you see that David Aldridge put out last week about how if the Heat make it, so now that is relevant because the Heat did make it, that if the Heat were to make the finals, that Pat Riley would then, as a player, coach, or executive, be a part of his 19th NBA Finals. Almost 25% of all NBA Finals.
Yeah, that's right. I remember that one. That's crazy.
That's
wild.
Outrageous.
Unbelievable.
19?
Yeah. Unreal.
19? And they said, I didn't realize this, they said during the broadcast, the Heat culture, which was established by Pat Riley 28 years ago when he took over as a coach. I was like, damn, man. He took over the Heat 28 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
How old am I? God. 28 years. That's like when they would talk about like Dean Smith being in North Carolina and shit. You'd be like, what? Pat Riley's been in Miami. You know what I mean? They'd be like, Jim Boeheim been in Syracuse for, and it always feels like, oh God, that guy's been there since, you know, before I was even born. You hear about these things, and it's like, I remember Pat Riley, like, I mean, going to the Heat. It's kind of crazy. And the fact that he established this 28 years ago, I was like, my God. 19 finals is, that's ridiculous. Just ridiculous. And this team is nowhere near a finals-built team. Like, they are 100% there because of Heat culture. That can never be mocked again. It really can't. Because this is the friggin' Mona Lisa of Heat culture. This is not Heat talent.
No, it's not.
It's Caleb Martin, Gabe Vincent, and like crazy Haywood Highsmith out there.
Yep.
And just incredible. Yeah. Incredible.